Just like your favorite rod and reel, a boat is a tool you have to be able to do your fishing job much better. I have the luxury here in the man cave of having three boats, and that is a luxury, folks, I'll tell you that. We've got the Polar Craft, great boat, very wide, very good boat for that, but it's 25 horsepower on this boat. The boat behind us back there is the old wash tub, and you've seen a lot of things done with it. One of the things that we have that for is we have a lot of horsepower restricted lakes where 10 horses is the limit. That we fish a lot of tournaments out of those lakes, and that's why we have that boat. Then to my right, of course, we have the Z520. It's a Ranger, it's a big boat. I can take it to Kentucky Lake or Gunnersville or Rayburn or wherever we may be fishing or shooting film. One of the things you have to look at when you get ready to buy a small boat, much like you do with a rod and reel, is what does it do and how does it perform? Wide boats are better. So if you get a 16 footer, that's okay, but try to get as wide a boat as you possibly can. It adds stability, it adds the ability to be able to not throw your partner out of the boat when you set the hook. It also adds some feature functionality, much like this Polar Craft does, to be able to add the right electronics, the right trolling motor, all those kind of things. We added a Talon to this boat, and the really neat thing about that is this is going to be a shallow water boat for us. It's going to be a small lake boat. We want to be able to fish it just like we would out of the big Ranger, with all the amenities it has. The same is true with the old wash tub. What we want to do with the Banshee is we want to have all the tools and capabilities in that boat to be able to fish better and more effectively. Just like your rod and reels we talked about earlier, you look at this as a tool. It's a very, very important tool. But make sure when you're out looking for a boat and you're trying to find out what you need in the way of a boat, look for width, look for quality, look for that good solid frame that you look for in a boat, and don't forget the trailer. Very, very important to get a good trailer under your boat because you're going to be towing it around. You want to make sure that that boat allows you to be able to get to where you want to and get back. So when you're looking at boats, again, I want to make sure you know that there's a boat for everybody. Whether your price tag is something like the old wash tub or something like this or even a Ranger, you want to look at that boat and look at for the feature functionality in each of those boats to be able to help you be a better fisherman.
If you want to activate the bass, you better have a HydroWave. You got six different bait fish sounds, you run it at any volume, you can see them actually come up to the speaker of the HydroWave. You can watch them come up off the bottom.
When you're fishing deep, the hardest one to catch is always the first one. With the HydroWave, you get them going faster.
HydroWave, I won't fish without it.